Hello everybody. In the last video, we talked about how security works in Kuzzle. And today we're gonna put everything we learned in a previous video into practice. So if you've missed the Kuzzle 5 tutorial, I really suggest you to watch that video before, because today we're not going to explain any notions, any new notions. We're gonna just put that into practice. So I am here in my admin console accessing my running instance. I access the admin console as console.kuzzle.io in my browser, and I'm in the security section and in the role menu. What we're gonna do today is add some permissions to the default role so that we are able to create a copywriter user. Okay? Actually, what we're gonna do is to create a whole new role, right? So that we can create a copywriter role. Copywriter here. As we've seen before, we have to specify controllers. Which controllers are we going to enable here? As we said, a copywriter must be able to create, delete, and update documents, right? So we target the document controller. And as actions, we want to enable create. We always have here to specify true. And next actions will be create, delete, and update. Okay? And here we are. We have our new copywriter role in the role list. Now, to associate this role to a user, we first have to associate the role to a profile. So we're going to add this role to the default profile. But what we are going to do is actually to associate through a new policy in order to restrict the scope of this role just to one collection. So we add a new object to the policies array. We specify the role ID called copywriter. And here we need to restrict the role to a specific index. We already have an index called test index here. So let me take a look if it's this, it's restricted to, and then we have an array inside. So restricted to is not an object, it's an array containing an object, containing a first attribute called index. And my index here will be test index. And next to index, I specify the set of collections that I want to enable within this index. So I specify collections at plural. And again, this will be an array. So my only element here will be test collection. So let's see if this works, if the indentation is good. Let's update the profile, and here we go. My default profile contains a new policy containing the copywriter role restricted to test index and test collection. Now, let's create our first copywriter user. Let's call him Luca. And let's associate to Luca the default profile. Let's describe here the credentials for Luca. So username Luca, and let's say test is the password. Let's save it. And here we go. We have our new copywriter Luca here. Let's see if something works here. I just logged out my admin console and I am logging in as Luca. I am actually logged in, but what happened? I can't see anything. Well, this is pretty normal. Before being able to edit content, I first have to see what's inside Kuzzle, right? I need to be able to list my content. And whenever we access the data section in the admin console, we first need to be able to list indexes and collections. So let's re-log in as admin. And let's add some new features to the copywriter Luca. I am actually going to create a new role called visitor because I think that any user that I want to be able to contribute to my system must at least be able to list the content. And I call it visitor. Visitor, and as before, I have my controllers here. So my controller will be first index, and the actions that I want to enable are list, just list. And there's another controller here that I want to enable, which is collection. And again, same action, list, that I can copy paste. If everything's okay, I create it. And here I have my visitor role. Now, only thing I have to do here is to add the visitor role to the default profile. And this is extremely easy. I just copy paste these lines here and I say visitor, visitor update. Now let's see if now Luca is able to do some more things. Luca test, and I log in, and here I am. I have my index list and I can see the collections inside. So, wow, what happens here? I just accessed my collection and I have a set of errors. This is not good. This is because whenever I access a collection, I need to be able to search for the content inside it, right? And I didn't grant that right to my user. So I re-log in as admin and I add some new ability to my visitor. I want to enable my visitor to be able to search all the documents within a collection. So I specify document here as the name of the controller, and within the actions, I add the search action. Everything should be okay. Now, since my copywriter is a default profile and the default profile contains the visitor role, everything should be okay. Let's check it. I go to my test index, test collection, and here I am. I can see the documents inside. I already have one document. And if I create a document here, I have an error, forbidden action, get mapping for user Luca. This is because whenever I want to create a new document in the admin console wants to show me the mapping of the documents, right? The mapping, sorry, of the collection. And I didn't grant that action to my user. So let's get back and add it to the copywriter role. Copywriter, because I want my copywriters to be able to fetch the mapping of the collections where they are working on. So in the collection controller, I want to enable one more action called getMapping. True. If I update the role and if I log in as Luca, let's see if I am able to create a new document. Something's wrong here. Let's see why I can't access here the mapping. I probably made a mistake. So one thing that I have to do here is to understand why this action that I have allowed here doesn't work. And what I do is, actually the documentation is my friend. So I go to the docs, I search for get mapping here, and I see that it's actually in the collection controller. What did I do? What did I do wrong? Okay, I made a mistake here in my... I actually specified the collection index within the document index. So I was wrong of one indentation level. So now if I update, it's right. I also misspelled the actions word. So if I update, everything should be fine. I have my copywriter here containing document and collection enabling the get mapping action. So if I log in as Luca here, I now go to my test collection, I create a document, and I actually can see a mapping and I can create a document. So let's create a new document called Alex and say that Alex is as a first name. It's called Alexandre. Then last name Boutinon, and his job title, his job is DevOps. And here we go, let's see if I can actually create a document. And here we are, I have my Alex document, which is next to my Luca document. Okay, this is all for now. As you can see, I have been able to progressively define the rights for my user. And whenever I had some problems, I could go to the documentation and take a look at how the API is structured, because of course we cannot know by heart all the API tree. So it's your time to play with the roles and the profile and the users. If you have any problem, you can join us on Gitter and we'll be very glad to help. I hope you had fun and I see you on the next tutorial.